You know, Mike, when I was a kid, sometimes I fantasized about being a bartender.
Sometimes I fantasize about Lonnie Anderson. Guess that's the difference between you and me.
I mean it. That'd be cool, slinging cocktails, talking people through their troubles. Like, take this gentleman here. I bet he could use a kind word.
$10 if you get that guy to say tater tot.
What?
Tater tot. You got 30 seconds, and you can't say it yourself, starting now.
Give me a bourbon, straight up. Yeah. Yeah. Right away. Listen, sir, you mind if I ask you?
I'll be right back.
Let's just take a second. Like, what do you call those tiny little fried potato nuggets? The tiny little nuggets? Do you know what they call them? The little ones? I'm thinking of serving on the snack bar camp for life. Do you remember what they're called? Do you know what they're called?
French fries?
No, not French fries, but they're like French fries. But they're
I gotta use the jar.
No, wait, please, they're cylindrical. They're small and they're about yay big, and they're cylindrical shaped, and they come frozen in a bag.
String beans?
No, they're potatoes. They're made of potatoes.
Sorry, man, I don't know.
No, crispy on the outside, tender on the inside.
Tater tots.
Tater tots! Tater tots! Oh! What a great save!
Oh!
Oh! 32 seconds! Oh!
Got there.
Body language. I'm learning how to read people like a book.
Does that really work?
Oh, yeah. Your gestures, your expressions, your posture, all I need is one glance and your secrets are mine to know.
All right. Go for it.
You're Dutch.
No, I'm not.
I'm sorry, Bosco. Your mouth says no, but your body says, hey, everybody, check me out. I'm Dutch.
Hey, Ed, remember me? Bob Arnovitz,
yeah.
Your old classmate.
Hey, Bob.
Hey.
How you doing?
Uh-uh. Do not answer that question. I will tell you how he's doing. He wants to have sex with you.
What?
So, Bob, I didn't know you were still in town. Have a seat. What are you up to these days?
I'm a clerk over at Staples.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, it doesn't pay much, but it's got its perks.
Like what?
Free whiteout.
Nice. So how can I help you?
I'm being sued.
Oh, yeah? You want to tell me about it?
Okay, well, for starters, you got to know that when it comes to women, I'm a lost cause.
Oh, I doubt that. Nice guy like you.
I have no money, I'm boring, and I'm built like a bag of peat moss. I haven't had a date in 3 years.
That's a shame.
Yeah, you know, it's just been one turn down after another. Sort of rough on the old self-esteem. So to cheer myself up, I started www.bobsrejections.com.
What's that?
Well, I spend a lot of time monkeying around on my uncle's computer. You know, I live with my Uncle Bernie.
Okay.
And I got one of those free websites. Mm-hmm. So every time a woman rejected me, I'd put her name on the website along with a picture, if I had one, and a description of how she turned me down.
I think I see where this is going.
Well, one of the women sued me. Her name is Joanne Clemson.
Breach of privacy. Whoa. $50,000. Wow. Looks like someone can't take a little joke.
Yeah, well, I guess it isn't that little. Last month, my website got 500,000 visitors.
What? How'd it get so popular?
I don't know. You know, I told a couple of guys at work. They thought it was funny and told their friends, and suddenly it's everywhere.
That's amazing. Did you profit from this in any way?
No. No, I wish. Ed, if I lose this case, my life is pretty much over. I won't make rent. Uncle Bernie will throw me out of the house. I'm putting my little brother through college. You know, so much for that. I'm in way over my head here. Do you think you can help me?
I can sure try. Let's get to work.
Great. Thanks, Ed.
Sup, Tommy?
Sup, Jakey?
Sup, Jess?
Hey, Warren.
Sup, Cheswick?
Oh, hey, kick-ass party the other night, man. It was awesome. I love those, like, super giant corn chips. Totally awesome for scooping.
Yeah.
Hey, can I like sit down with you guys or?
Yeah, I have a seat one.
Oh, cool, cool. How's the fried mozzarella?
What?
They're mozzarella sticks.
Right, mozzarella.
What are you talking about?
That's how the real Italians say it. Aia mozzarella! Hey, you laughing at that? Hey, you laughing at this? Hey, forget about it, huh?
Okay, goodbye, Mrs. Humphrey. When you'll schedule your next appointment.
Thank you, Doctor.
Dale. Dale. Thursday, come no more, Dr. Jerome. Dale. He said 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 Dale. Thursday, come no more, Dr. Jerome.
Dr. Burton?
Yeah, Wendy?
Dr. Jerome would like to see you before you go.
I told Nance to be home early tonight. Can I wait till tomorrow?
He said it was important.
All right, I'll be over in a few minutes.
Hi, I'm looking for a Bob Arnowitz. I was told I could find him here.
Yeah, he's in with Ed. Hey, you look really familiar.
Maybe you've seen me on Court TV.
Johnny Cochran.
Gary Seringo.
Do you own a guinea pig?
No.
Hamster?
No.
Gerbil?
Could I see Mr. Arnowitz, please?
One moment, please.
Ferret?
No.
Yeah?
Ed, celebrity super lawyer Gary Seringo is here to see Mr. Arnowitz.
What? Gary Seringo?
Yes. He's at the shoe counter talking to Phil about domesticated rodents.
Oh, my God. That's Gary Seringo.
Is it really him?
No.
Hey. Hi, Mr. Seringo. Hi, I'm Ed Stevens.
Oh, you're the lawyer.
That's right.
And that means you must be Bob Arnowitz.
Arnowitz. It's great to meet you.
Oh, thanks. I can't believe you're actually in my bowling alley. This is amazing. I'm a huge fan. I've been following your career ever since I was pretty much in all your Supreme Court arguments. But what are you doing in the bowling alley?
I'm sorry. Where do I know you from? Did you replace Wapner?
No, Phil, you're looking at Gary Seringo, the man who brought big tobacco to his knees. This is one of the greatest. Why are you here, sir?
Do you have any idea how important your lawsuit is?
Bob's lawsuit? Well, $50,000 is a lot of money.
Yeah, I work at Staples.
I'm not talking about the money. I'm talking about every American's right to free speech. Now, Mr. Arnowitz, I saw your website. Did you post anything that wasn't true?
Not at all. I just wrote what happened.
Yeah, and you're being sued for it.
Yeah.
Being sued for telling the truth. You see, the internet is so young, the legal system can't handle the fact that regular people like Bob Arnowitz can be heard by millions. Gentlemen, you have a landmark First Amendment case here.
Wow. How do you even know about it?
I had my staff combing the books for a lawsuit like this for months. 3 minutes after I heard about it, my ass hit the back seat of a cab. Mr. Stevens, I want to join you as co-counsel in this case.
What?
Mm-hmm.
You? That would be an incredible honor, sir.
That is, if it's all right with Mr. Arnowitz.
Hell yeah, Mr. Seringo. Sign me up.
No charge, of course.
Yeah.
How do you ever talk me into joining Spanish clubs?
Quit complaining. Flip the damn tortilla. It's gonna scorch.
Big news, my homies. Warren P. Cheswick has discovered the Holy Grail.
The Holy Grail?
Yes. I have found the key to eternal popularity. The key to Jessica Martel.
I don't want to hear this now. I come to Spanish Club to relax.
Mark, Diane, I'm about to become the class clown.
Oh, boy.
No, just listen. I snuck out to the goat for lunch today, right? And I sat with Tommy, Jakey, and Jessica, and I totally had them cracking up. The guys were like, ha! And Jessica was loving me. She was loving me.
That's odd. I've never found you funny.
Oh, sure you do.
Maybe average funny, but not whose line is it anyway funny.
Yeah, well, today it was my line anyway.
Warren, this is not good.
Not good? What are you talking about?
Walk with me.
Whoa! Crap. Senora Henderson!
Warren, you are making a huge fundamental mistake.
Oh, yeah, what's that?
We're trying to get you into the inner circle, right?
Yeah.
Okay, well, the class clown is not a true member of the inner circle. He's a jester, a mascot, a source of entertainment. And he never gets any action.
Oh, says who?
Wake up, Cheswick.
Ow.
The leading man gets the girl, not the wacky sidekick. I'm going down the wrong road with this.
Oh, please, Diane, the only reason you don't like it is you didn't think of it.
Oh, really?
Yeah, really.
Okay, fine. Suit yourself. Clown it up.
Hey, don't hate the player, hate the game!
Dr. Burton is here to see you.
Send him in, Wendy.
Hi.
Please sit down, Dr. Burton.
All right.
I'm aware that you and Wendy are planning a retirement party for me. I'd like you to call it off.
Okay, well, we just thought you'd want to have a chance to say goodbye to your patients.
I'm not ready to say goodbye.
Okay, well, we already bought the cake. But another day in the fridge shouldn't hurt. You let us know when you're ready, and
perhaps
we'll...
I'm not being clear. I've decided to postpone my retirement.
Postpone. Okay. Postpone. Postpone. Okay. Well, you're supposed to retire on Thursday. So what then? You wanna wait till Monday? Have one last weekend as a doctor? That's fine. We'll just put the cake in the freezer and we'll defrost it on Monday, and you'll retire on Monday.
Dr. Burton, I'm not retiring. I'm going to keep the practice.
No, Dr. Jerome, you can't do that.
Of course I can. I've got several good years in me.
No, you don't, Dr. Jerome. You have no good years left in you. You're old. You're very, very old, Dr. Jerome.
I'm in perfectly good health.
Well, you said I'd inherit the practice. You promised me that.
And you will, just not yet.
No, Dr. Jerome, now. Mm-hmm, now. I'm taking over the practice now. You're retiring now. Wendy?
Dr. Burton?
Wendy, we need the cake. We need the cake, Wendy. Dr. Jerome's retiring. Serve the cake, Wendy. Dr. Jerome's retiring in 5 minutes. Serve the cake, Wendy.
Dr. Burton, control yourself.
No, Dr. Jerome, you control yourself. You control yourself. I quit.
What?
Oh, yeah. You heard me, Dr. Jerome. I'm done with you. I quit.
Wendy?
Yes, Dr. Jerome?
Don't serve the cake.
He's 40 minutes late. Think you forgot about us?
Oh, no. Mr. Stringo's an important guy. He's probably caught up in a conference call or something.
All right.
Tell you what, why don't we do this without him? You can just fill him in later.
Yeah, okay.
What I would like you to do, Bob, is, walk me through the night you asked out, join Clemson. Just give me all the details.
All right. Well, I walked into the goat through that door over there, and I saw Joanne sitting where you are now.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought, hey, there's my dental hygienist.
Huh.
Did I mention she's my dental hygienist?
No.
She's my dental hygienist.
Uh-huh.
And I've always thought she was cute, so I figured I'd take a shot. You know, so I walked over like this, and said, excuse me, Joanne. Hi, Bob Arnovitz. And she said, oh, hi. And I said, hey, can I buy you a drink? And she said, I don't think so, Captain Staples.
Ouch.
And then she and her friends just started laughing in my face.
Her friends?
Yeah, she was sitting here with 5 or 6 other people. Now everyone was looking around to see what they were laughing at. It was really embarrassing. What?
You just won yourself a case, my friend.
Hey, Nancy, you know what I want to do when we're done here?
What?
I want to guzzle champagne and devour heaping mounds of caviar.
Yeah.
Yes, for today's a day of celebration. My wings are unfurled. The wind is at my back. I'm king of all that I survey in you, Nance.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
You are my queen.
Ooh, so I'd be Nancy, queen of...
Oh, Mrs. Burton, to what do I owe this delight?
Well, I'm helping my husband pack up his things and get the hell out of here.
Well, before your husband prances off, he might want to take a quick look at the contract he signed when he took this job. A contract which keeps him under my employment for another 2 years, unless I choose to retire before then, which I do not.
Come on, Dr. Jerome.
Always a pleasure, Mrs. Burton.
Mm-hmm. But he can't really make you stay here, can he?
Yeah, I think he can, Nance. But he's not going to want to.
Ladies!
Hey, Warren.
I'd like you to meet a close personal friend of mine. Mr. Belly!
Oh, my God!
Hey, say hello, Mr. Belly.
Hello, my name is Mr. Belly. Belly, Belly, Belly. I come from the land of Billies.
You're crazy. I gotta go. Bye, Warren. Oh.
Bye-bye. Adios.
Auf Wiedersehen. Class clown.
Deep breath in. Out. Good.
Dr. Jerome, what kinds of things they teach in med school back in 1906? Hi, Mr. Schreier.
Hi. Dr. Burton, you're swimming in very dangerous waters.
Woo-hoo. Looks like someone got a little cavalier at Mr. Gittleson's prostate problem.
Is that tic-tac-sized brain of yours completely short-circuited?
Hey, buddy, I'm just looking out for the patients. Frankly, I'm starting to get a little concerned about some of your decisions lately.
You're questioning my decisions?
Oh, yeah. Show of hands. Who here is operating with a 30-year-old playbook? That's right, it's Wally.
Dr. Burton, I know what you're trying to do here, but this is neither the time nor the place.
Mr. Schreier, you're being treated by a 96-year-old squid. I'm going to throw out two words here that you should seriously consider because they just might save your life. Second opinion.
Leave my exam room immediately, Dr. Burton.
You got it, Wally.
Excuse me. Dr. Burton?
Hey, what do you got for me, Sporto?
If you think these tactics will make Walter Jerome buckle, you are very sadly mistaken.
You know, I'm just noticing it. You're a tiny man, you know that?
I will not fire you, Dr. Burton. I will keep you here so long your body will decay.
Yeah, very, diminutive.
Fine, we'll play it your way.
I can actually look down and see the top of your head. How about that? By the way, you ever thought about using some Rogaine on that melon of yours?
Good day, Dr. Burton.
Hey, you're tiny.
Good morning, Ed.
Hey, Mr. Sringle.
Sorry I missed you at the bar last night.
Oh, not to worry. Please, have a seat. Shirley! Could you bring Mr. Sringle a cup of coffee? Or a corn dog?
No, thank you.
I'm sorry. Mr. Stringle, I don't mean to step on your toes, but I think I've got a way to win this case.
Really? What's that?
Okay, well, Joanne Clemson is suing for invasion of privacy. She says that Bob Artemis made their private encounter public when he posted it on the internet.
Right.
But what she's not saying is that she rejected the guy at full volume in front of a bar full of friends and strangers. She was playing to a crowd.
And by doing so, she voluntarily gave up her right to privacy.
That's right. So lawsuit's groundless. Case closed. You know, we really got lucky here. That First Amendment defense would not have been easy.
No, but I think we'll stick with it just the same.
Yeah. What? Wait, I'm sorry, we're not going to use the privacy argument?
Don't think so, no.
Wait, Mr. Stringle, I'm confused. Doesn't the privacy argument guarantee us a win?
Yeah, probably so. But winning isn't everything. You know what, Ed? I think I'm going to have that corn dog.
Winning isn't everything. I don't understand. You don't want to win?
Are you starting to go small town on me here, Ed?
No, of course not. I'm not going... What does that mean?
Well, sometimes a cause is bigger than a man.
Sometimes a cause... Okay. I got to come clean with you, Mr. Stringle. I haven't been this lost since Mr. Ivanovich tried to teach me algebra with a thick Czechoslovakian accent.
Ed.
Yeah?
If we lose, what happens?
We appeal.
To a district court. And then if we just happen to lose again?
We...
Oh my God, you want to keep losing and then keep appealing all the way to where?
That's right.
Are you talking about the...
Yes, Ed, I am.
Would you mind saying it so I'm absolutely sure we're both talking about the same thing?
The
Supreme Court. You want to argue this thing all the way to the Supreme Court?
It's the only way it's going to get the attention it deserves. We went here, so what? We need to get this before the folks that interpret the laws for the whole country.
Wow.
Now, you want to stay on as co-counsel? You're welcome to come along for the ride.
But then wouldn't... In this case, would then stay tied up in court for years.
Ed.
Yeah.
The Internet is uncharted territory, fresh snow. We have a chance to make the first tracks here. It's worth being tied up in court for years. This is no small town case. You've stumbled into the big time. Oh, thank you. Delightful.
Hello, I'm back. Oh, I got a little present for you. I think you are going to be pretty happy about, my friend. Steakums.
Good evening, Mrs. Burton.
Oh, God. Mike, you scared the steakums out of me.
Oh, yes, yes. Sorry to startle you. I just thought since that buffalo-brained husband of yours wasn't here, you might want to get it on with one Dr. Walter Jerome.
Mike, what are you doing?
We go like this to work tomorrow, Nance. Dr. Jerome's going to flip.
You can't do that.
Oh, Nance, this is a war. If Dr. Jerome doesn't want to fire me, I'm going to make his life a living hell. You take a look at this bald cap. This is a professional quality bald cap. Bought a kid at the costume store, $12.
Honey, I really think you're starting to lose it here a little bit.
Dr. Drum's going to be the one who loses it tomorrow when I show up and prance around the office telling all his patients, I'm Dr. Jerome and I'm out of my gourd.
Mike.
What?
Honey, is this really the way you want things to end with you and Dr. Jerome?
What do you mean?
Well, you know, you and Dr. Jerome have been through a lot together.
What are you, taking Dr. Jerome's side? Never take sides against the family, Nance.
I hate the man. You know that.
Well, in that case, we can stay married.
But is this really how you want things to end with him?
You ever feel small, Mike?
What do you mean?
Look at us. We're small-town guys, spending the evening sitting on the roof of a bowling alley trying to throw ice cubes into a garbage can. Other people are out there doing stuff.
Yeah.
1916.
I know. Yeah, we should get out of this town. I, for one, like to move far away from Dr. Walter Jerome.
I think this guy's Siringo. This guy's actually out to change the world. Should we be trying to change the world, Mike?
2016. Sure, let's change the world, Ed, just as soon as I finish my beer.
And Siringo knows that we could win this case for Bob Arnovitz in a heartbeat, but instead he's trying to go all the way to the Supreme Court. 2017.
Why?
That's what I said. Why? Because you and I, we think small. Siringo thinks big. He thinks big. He's thinking about the Supreme Court. I mean, he's thinking about the Supreme Court.
Yep. But he's not thinking about Bob Arnovitz. Anyone. 3-2 in the series, game 6.
Okay, class, as you know, today is teacher-student day. When we switch roles, you get to teach, and I get to sit back and make fun of you. All right, so today, to show us everything that he knows about George Orwell's Animal Farm is our very own Warren Cheswick. Warren. Oh, don't tell me you chickened out. Well, that's a shame.
Hello, class. It's me, Miss Stacy.
Oh, boy.
Oh, yes. Can we take our seats, please, everyone? Thank you. Now, class, can anyone tell me why George Orwell uses Napoleon, a talking pig, in Animal Farm? Mr. Manicore. I'm sorry, no, that is incorrect. Because when he was writing it, he was obviously using crack cocaine.
I'm sorry, Miss Bessie, I'm not sure that that is the interpretation accepted
lady,
by...
If you care to address this class, I'd appreciate if you raised your hand. Thanks.
Pardon me for interrupting.
You're lucky I don't give you detention.
Oh, what a beautiful morning. Yes, what a wonderful day. I want y'all to know, I've got a beautiful feeling.
everything. I got everything. I got everything. Woo! Everything's going my way.
Hi, Ed. Where's Bob?
He'll be here in a moment.
Boy, that little pond you have in the center of town is a beauty. I just saw a bunch of kids playing hockey on it. Norman Rockwell, grab your brush.
Mr. Sringo, I can't do this.
You can't do what?
I can't sacrifice Bob Arnovitz for a cause.
Ed, just when it looks like you're starting to think of the big picture, you have a relapse.
Bob Arnovitz didn't hire me to think of the big picture. Bob Arnovitz hired me to think of Bob Arnovitz.
Look, Ed, I've dedicated my life to making a difference. This is a chance to make a big difference. I'm not going to let that chance go.
So what do we do?
Well, I think it's time you withdraw from the case.
Withdraw?
Yeah. You and I are co-counsel. We can't agree on an approach. Something's got to give. You should withdraw.
Well, I can't do that, Mr. Sringo.
Remember who I am, Ed? I'm the guy that helped bring down Big Tobacco. I'm the guy that made it illegal to sell semi-automatic weapons in 14 states.
Yeah, well, I'm the guy Bob Arnovitz came to and said, I need your help.
Okay.
Dr. Jerome, may I have a moment? Dr. Jerome, I came here today fully prepared to try to get you to fire me by taking our little war up to the next level.
Fine with me, Dr. Burton. Let the rockets red glare.
I've decided against it.
What?
I don't want things to end this way.
What exactly are you saying?
Well, Dr. Jerome, may I be honest with you?
Go ahead.
I think you're a nasty and bitter old man. And, in many ways, working with you these past 3 years has been a living hell. But, for that, I get to witness some things I never would have witnessed working in the biggest and best hospital in the country. Got to witness a man take care of not an individual, not a family, but a town. And, in return for that privilege, I'm going to stay here and honor my contract. How difficult things will be between us, that's up to you.
Hey, Warren.
Oh, hey, Jess. How's it going?
That thing you did yesterday in Miss Bessie's class, that was the funniest thing I've ever seen.
Well, I just figured the class could use a little lighter take on teacher-student day. You know, break it up a little.
I can't believe you did that. I mean, that was awesome when you said, Miss Richard, if you raise your hand, I'm going to give you a detention.
Actually, it was, if you don't raise your hand, but whatever. Yeah, I like to have some fun with Carol every once in a while. You know, she's really a good kid.
You're really, really funny, Warren.
Well, you know, I've always felt that laughter is like a salve for the soul, you know? I mean, let's face it, every time the clown comes on, he steals the show, right?
Definitely.
So just what say you and I after school, we slide over to Starbucks and grab us a couple of lattes. Or a mochaccino, if you want. Or they have those, like, tiazzi things. You know, the fruity ones. Martha me, that's a refreshing beverage.
I'm sorry, Warren. I've got some stuff I gotta do.
Oh. Oh, that's cool. Totally cool.
Sorry.
No, don't be ridiculous. Cool. Totally and incredibly cool. I'm sorry. In fact, now that you mention it, I don't even know what I was thinking. I actually couldn't have, even if you had said yes, I've got to help my uncle build a log cabin today, so, you know, totally cool. Forget about it. Maybe some other time. Maybe some other time when we're not both so caught up with these crazy schedules.
Yeah. Listen, I gotta go.
Okay.
See ya.
Yeah. Not if I see you first.
I wonder how many languages I can say I told you so in.
She thought I was hilarious. I mean, all the Playboy centerfolds always say their number one turn-on is a guy with a sense of humor.
Well, there's a simple explanation for that.
What?
You're lying.
I just don't get it. I don't get it. I killed in that classroom. I killed! And she was cracking up at everything I did.
Cheswick, I told you. The class clown doesn't get the girl.
Dude, that Carol Vesey thing was awesome.
Hey, thanks, Russell.
Bob, we have something we want to discuss with you.
Yeah?
Would you like to go first?
No, you go ahead.
Very well. I'm not even sure how to say this, but I believe that Ed is trying to lose this case on purpose.
What?
This is a very juicy case for a guy like Ed. He feels that if he loses and then we appeal, maybe he can take it all the way to the Supreme Court.
He's lying. You're lying.
Ed, you're going to have your turn.
I'll take my turn now. Bob, how long have we known one another?
Since high school.
Okay.
But we didn't really keep in touch.
Bob, this man is lying to you, all right? He's the one trying to take the case all the way to the Supreme Court. He's the one trying to lose it on purpose. He told me so himself. You told me so
yourself. I did say that I would fight for Bob all the way to the Supreme Court if I had to. But Bob, believe me, I've been to the Supreme Court twice, and it's no great thrill for me to go back.
Okay, Bob, now, the woman that's suing you, all right, when she rejected you, she did so loudly and in public, right? This is a very relevant fact because she cannot then claim that you violated her privacy, all right? Do you understand that? If we introduce this fact, we win, all right?
Bob, you're going to have to make a choice. Do you go with my approach or Ed's?
Well, I'm sorry, Ed. Let's listen to Mr. Siringo. He's been on the TV. But I want to keep Ed on.
Absolutely. And don't you worry, Ed. You'll get another shot at the Supreme Court. I know that was hard for you, Bob.
Yeah.
But we have to discuss testimony. I'll call you later, okay?
I can see that you are upset.
It's a little late to be bowling, isn't it, Earl Anthony?
Earl Anthony, nice. I'll buy you dinner if you can name two more professional bowlers.
Dick Weber.
Wow. Okay. Now you're scaring me. Okay, one more.
Earl Anthony.
That's what I thought, my friend. What are you doing here so late?
I was driving by, saw the light was on, wanted to find out how my favorite bowling alley lawyer was doing.
Well, I feel...
What?
Small.
Small?
Yeah. Yeah.
Let me use my superpower-like tools of deduction. Gary Siringo.
Yeah, that's the guy.
How's it going in court?
Just the way he wants it to.
He's losing on purpose?
Yeah. It's subtle, but yeah. Yeah. I mean, all I'd have to do is get in the evidence about the woman rejecting Bob in public. He won't do it.
You explain that to Bob.
Yeah, I tried, but the guy in the slick suit from the TV outtalked the guy in the bowling shirt from the small town.
Well, if it's any consolation at all, I think you look damn cute in the bowling shirts.
Thanks.
Vern Stanley.
What?
Professional bowler. You owe me dinner, my friend.
I've never heard of a professional bowler named Vern Stanley.
What? Vern Stanley? Vern Stanley? Was my second grade violin teacher.
Dr. Jerome.
Do you shoot pool, Dr. Burton?
Yeah, I guess.
Come with me.
Mr. Siringo, your closing statement, please.
Thank you, Your Honor. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I need you to open up your small-town minds and try to understand a pretty difficult concept. Free speech. Now, I know you live simple, protected lives here in Stickyville.
Stickyville.
But in the name of justice, I need you all to leap forward and come join me in the 21st century.
You see what he's doing? He's insulting them.
Now, the Constitution was written in ink with a quill on parchment paper.
Amendments are items amended to or added to the Constitution.
Let me let you in a little secret, Bob. There's one surefire way to tell when a jury isn't buying a lawyer. They don't make eye contact. Humble beginnings. See? No eye contact. 50 states,
big country. Come on, Bob, let me help you. Let me bottom line it for you here, folks. You should find for my client, Bob Arnovitz. I mean, would a famous lawyer like me steer you the wrong way?
Of course not.
People, you gotta trust me on this one.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You all have a nice day. Nothing further, sir.
Something further.
What?
I'd like to add to the close.
Your Honor, the defense has concluded its final statement.
No, it hasn't.
Your Honor, I'm the lead counsel in this case, and I'm saying we are finished.
We're not finished.
I am going to count to three, and when I get to three, I expect you to have settled your little dispute.
Ed, don't do this.
I have to.
Three. And what will be, counselors? Are we done or not done?
We're done.
We're not done.
Stralovitz, your representation has put you in a very compromising position.
I want Ed.
Bob, you're making a big mistake. I'm telling you.
Mr. Stevens, you may add to the closing statement.
Thank you, Your Honor.
I object.
What law school did you go to, TV boy?
Ladies and gentlemen, the jury. Hi. Listen, the other day, Mr. Siringo called me a small town guy. Said if I just get out of the way, this case could go all the way to the Supreme Court. Impact the laws of the land. But Mr. Siringo's right. I am a small town guy with one small responsibility. And that is look out for my client, Bob Arnovitz. Now, you're all missing one crucial fact in this case, and that is, when Joanne Clemson rejected my client, she did so loudly and
from a large objection on so many grounds, I don't even have time to list them.
She cannot
all.
Make the claim that her privacy was violated.
Mr. Stevens, is this some kind of practical joke? You cannot introduce evidence now.
I have no choice, Your Honor.
Why not?
Because Mr. Siringo here is trying to lose his trial on purpose so he can appeal it all the way up to the Supreme Court.
That's ridiculous, Your Honor.
I am not a very happy man right now, but I have no choice but to declare a mistrial. We'll start again tomorrow. And, Mr. Siringo, I will find out if what Mr. Stevens says is true.
What happens now?
You go to trial my way.
It's not going
to
be a trial.
Why not?
Because you know they can't win. You're dropping the charges. It's over, Bob.
You're amazing. You saved my life.
Bobby.
Now you're a pretty good lawyer, Ed. Too bad you're gonna be stuck in Stuckeyville.
I like it here just fine.
Four ball corner pocket. Seven ball corner pocket. Like picking chicken, Dr. Burton, like picking chicken. Two on the side.
11 in the corner.
That was quite a speech today, Dr. Burton.
Reminded me of someone.
Who's that, Dr. Jerome?
Young doctor I once knew quite well. Smart, a little too brash for my taste, but busting with the unbridled exuberance of youth.
That was you. Your first starting out, it was you.
No, Lenny Stitzel, the guy I went to med school with. Started a practice way before he was ready, didn't realize what he was getting into. Lost everything.
Dr. Jerome, I'm ready. I'm gonna bank this five in the corner.
That's just the shot I would have taken when I was your age. Now I have the experience to know it'll never go in.
Oh, sure it will.
Not unless Sir Isaac Newton comes in and rejiggers the laws of physics.
Well, here's one for youthful exuberance, Dr. Jerome.
You really think you're ready to start your own practice, Dr. Burton?
Yes, sir, I do.
In that case, Dr. Burton, you're fired. Night.
Dr. Jerome? Thank you.
All right, let's go. Spill it. What's the matter?
Oh, nothing. Jessica Martell doesn't go out with guys like me.
Guys like you. What does that mean?
That's the same old stuff. She needs the big man on campus.
You know, Warren, there's nothing wrong with being the little guy.
Yeah, there is if you want to go out with Jessica Martel.
Well, maybe that's Jessica Martel's problem. Wait, where are you?
Oh, there, Colonel.
You pretty happy there? What?
Just got fired.
Are you serious?
Yeah!
That's great,
yeah.
Right?
Going out my own, man.
Yeah, Mike.
Next time.
Hey, can I talk to you for a minute?
Sure.
I want to thank you.
Why is that?
For not going out with me. Yeah, because I don't think it'd work out between us. So you go spend your life with Jakey and Foscat and guys like that. But that's where you belong. Yeah, I'll see you around.
Warren. Jakey and Foscat, I don't even... Warren, do you want to go to the movies or something sometime?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
That's really great. Wow. Good for you. Hey.
Hey.
How'd that go?
Fine. Fine. Going out with Jessica Martel. Oh. No big deal.
What? Are you kidding me?
Yep. Dude, be cool.
That's great, Warren. Wow. Well, let me see if I got you straight. I got the mistrial. You got your own practice. You got the girl. I think there's only one thing for three small town guys at Augusta to do at a time like this. Am I right, Mike?
You're right, Ed.
But strip club or strippers?
Oh, no. You gotta flick the wrist, my friend.
Just give me a beer.
Just flick the wrist.
Flick.
Not what he had, my
rookie tonight.
I think this strip club would have been a little more celebratory.
Oh, yes.